Endeavour Houston, we see a nominal MECO. Welcome to space.
Hey, it's Ben here. Docking is an integral part of modern spaceflight. It is the physical connection of two spacecraft in space. And to do this, we are going to look at three main parts. First is how we actually get that fine control over the position and rotation of our spacecraft. The next is something called station keeping, and then that approach for the docking. And then finally, the docking itself, actually physically connecting the two spacecraft together. We control our spacecraft precisely using reaction control systems. What a reaction control system is just a set of small thrusters around the spacecraft. And it is called a reaction control system because of Newton's third law of motion, which is often phrased as every action has an equal and opposite reaction. Here's the way I like to think of it. It's as if we've got two blocks on the table here, squished, a spring between them, and then let go. They are both pushed apart by the spring. So in a spacecraft, this is how the thruster works. It combusts fuel in the combustion chamber, making pressure, releasing gas out the back. The gas is one of the blocks, the spacecraft is the other block, and the pressure produced in the combustion chamber is that spring, pushing the two apart from each other. When we use our reaction control system, we'll see that there's actually no air resistance in space because it's, well, space. So we'll keep going, and if we want to slow down, then we'll have to fire our reaction control system in the opposite direction to then stop that speed that we've added in. We can also rotate our spacecraft using a reaction control system by firing thrusters on the opposite side of the spacecraft in opposite directions, just like this. And again, there's no air resistance, so to stop the rotation, we'll have to fire into the opposite direction again. Now, the thing with reaction control system thrusters is that they're made to be highly reliable and fire lots and lots of times, usually in quite short, specific bursts. So to do this, they often use hypergolic propellants. What hypergolic propellants means is that they don't really need an ignition source. You can just pump the fuel into the combustion chamber, which is made of two chemicals. And when those two chemicals contact each other, they'll spontaneously combust, producing that pressure and the gas going out the back. So that's how a reaction control system works. Now let's look at station keeping and approach. Station keeping is essentially just firing our reaction control system every now and then to make sure that we hold the same position relative to our target. We'll use the International Space Station since that's what's often being docked to these days. So if we're in orbit, we know that different altitudes relate to different speeds of orbits. You'll know this if you saw my last video about rendezvous. And we might be near the space station like this, but our orbit doesn't exactly match the space station's. That'd be really hard to do. And as such, we're gonna drift away because we'll be at a slightly different speed to the space station. So in order to stay in the same relative position, we're just gonna have to fire our reaction control thrusters every now and then to stay in that fixed relative position until we're given a go to dock. Once we're given the go to dock, we can fire our reaction control system to move us towards the space station. And you'd think that might be all we have to do, but there's a bit more of a complication because we are actually in orbit. So let's think about this in the frame of the orbit here. When we fire our thrusters towards the space station here, that's all well and good. We're going towards the space station, but we're not necessarily going towards the space station. We're going towards the direction that the space station happens to be at in that point in time. If we go a quarter of the way around the orbit, we can see that direction is actually pointed upwards relative to the space station. So when we fired it here, we'll find ourselves going towards the space station. But once we get a quarter of the way around, we'll find ourselves going up. Because of this, as we go around the orbit while we're docking, we actually have to make sure that we're firing our reaction control system to account for this, to keep our approach speed in the direction of the International Space Station until we get close enough that we're actually going to have our docking port physically contact with the docking port on the International Space Station. Let's talk about that. There are three main docking systems used on the International Space Station right now. One of them technically isn't a docking system, it's actually a berthing system, a little more on that later. So the first one that we're going to look at is a Russian one, and it's on the Russian segment of the International Space Station. There's quite a few of these docking ports, and they're used for docking the Russian Soyuz and Progress spacecraft. They are a docking port of a design called SSVP, which stands for Система стыковки внутреннего перехода. That is Russian, and it translates to System for Docking and Internal Transfer. It works using a probe and a drogue. The probe is on the arriving spacecraft, and the drogue is on the space station. The drogue is just a cone, really, with this area in the middle for the probe to latch into. When the reaction control system on the spacecraft is firing, it's pushing the spacecraft in that direction of the drogue. The probe contacts the drogue, and it is then, because of the cone shape, pushed into the center there, allowing for a margin of error. Once the probe reaches the center of that drogue, it can latch in. And once it latches in, the probe will start to retract, pulling the spacecraft in to a proper fit, at which point the proper locks will latch into place, holding the spacecraft to the space station, at which point the probe and drogue together open up as a hatchway for astronauts to go through. The next docking system is called the International Docking Standard, and it's not really a system, because standard is the key word there. It's actually an instruction booklet on how to build a compatible spacecraft that will be able to dock at the International Space Station's International Docking Adapters. There are two of these, and they're located on the Harmony module in the US segment. The advantage of having this standard is that it means that different companies and different countries can build spacecraft that are able to dock there without having to pay expensive fees to any specific company or government. Now, there are two spacecraft in development right now that are going to be using this docking adapter in 2019. They're the SpaceX Dragon and the Boeing Starliner. It works by having this target ring on the International Space Station, and then a ring on the arriving spacecraft. But that ring on the arriving spacecraft is held with these actuators that can move it about and rotate it slightly. That way there's a margin for error, since the reaction control system can't get a precise fit of those rings. When the spacecraft approaches, those actuator arms will line the two rings up, and then they will push together, at which point those rings will lock together, and then the arms can retract, pulling the spacecraft in, at which point a seal will be formed, some checks will be done, and then the astronauts can open the hatches and go through into the space station. The next system is called the Common Berthing Mechanism. It's technically not a docking port, because a docking port is something you can attach to while using your own reaction control system to maneuver you into position. The common berthing mechanism just requires way too much precision for that, because it's literally just these two rings that end up getting locked together. As such, we have to use the space station's robotic Canada arm to perform that precise fitting. The advantage with the common berthing mechanism is that it has quite a large diameter, so it's great for cargo supply craft like the SpaceX Dragon and the Northrop Grumman Cygnus. It's also great because it's used to actually attach all the modules on the US segment of the space station together, because again, that large ring allows them to transport equipment and experiments through those common berthing mechanisms between the modules. So that's docking and also berthing. It's simply space.